This movie is a horrific piece of dog shit, and I cannot help but enjoy watching every minute of it, and I don't know why. There's some part of my monkey brain that keeps going, hey, this is a good movie, keep watching, you stupid fuck, and I'm just sitting here like, no, I'm not. But eventually, I paid attention to the both dialogue, the characters, setting, plot, and I thought to myself, wow, I just got red-pilled.
There's a joke here somewhere.
And I know what you're gonna ask, why did you get red-pilled? This movie is just mediocre in general. Well, considering the fact that the main villain is clearly an allegory for Glacine Maxwell, which I think was Jeffrey Epstein's girlfriend, and the fact there's so many political allegories and satire in this fucking movie, it's hard to overlook. I mean, it's clear the pigs are the federal government constantly being oblivious and, you know, kind of fucking stupid at everything. Bomb is the, you know, the happy-go-lucky, naive cunts who don't believe anything's wrong. Red is the cynical, jaded bastards of the society, you know, just how fucked up the U.S. government is. And Chuck is Chuck. He doesn't really have, like, an allegory. He's just there. Then Silver, they're the ones to... Silver and this Courtney Broad, brought by Awkwafina, of all people, are the clear culprits of this scenario because they let this go on far too long, even though they're within knowledge that this is happening. Now, Silver might be an allegory for Facebook, maybe Twitter, because she's a bird. And Courtney might be, like, kicked or LinkedIn because... I don't know, she's just such a bland character, I can't think of a fucking analogy. Mighty Eagle might be like the hardest character like to compare to a real world equivalent, because he could be Jeffrey Epstein himself, the deep state within every government on the fucking planet that traffics children and women and men all over the planet. It could be, Hollywood's executives like Matt Lauer, Harvey Weinstein, one of the Cuomo brothers. He could even be all of us. He'd be a collective representative of all the pedophiles on the nation, all having this kind of love-hate relationship with Maxwell. Yes, they hate him because she's all-powerful and can, like that, snap them all away. At the same time, this is where they get all the kids from. This movie is quite brilliant in its writing, actually, and it's actually quite funny. This is a solid 10 out of 10. I could not recommend anything else over this. Oh, also, one more thing. There's a one-off joke in the movie about comparing Glacine Maxwell, how she's going to buy up all the islands and just like, turn them into their own personal resorts. And you want to know where resorts are? Full of fucking kiddie porn and shit like that. You know, all the cuties and other shit that you can have. This is a nice one-off joke. I actually kind of liked this. I laughed way too fucking hard at this scene. And the allegories for islands may not even be islands. Maybe like the United States, Canada, fucking... France, they've been bought and sold already, but, you know, these, first world Western nations that are, like, all powerful, all, like, full of money, guns, nuclear fucking weaponry, and they just want to buy them so they can have, like, a place to safely diddle kids and perform satanic blood orgies.